Hey everyone, this is Chris from Streams Church bringing you another Keys tutorial. Today we are going over the song This Is Amazing Grace as performed by Phil Wickham. This song is, I believe, originally in the key of B. I'm sorry, B flat. Typically at Streams we play it in the key of either A or D. And either of those times we will always have the keys transposed to be playing in the key of C, just to keep it consistent across the board. So let's jump right in. Let me get us into perform mode here. So we have three main sections. The first is a lead one section that we'll play on intro and instrumental one, I believe, and the outro. And then we have lead two, which we will play on the choruses. And then we have pad one, in which we will be playing root notes on the verses and optionally on the choruses. If you can handle playing the root notes with lead two on the choruses, great. If you only want to focus on lead two and leave out the root notes of pad one on the choruses, then that is obviously fine. And then finally we have pad two. Pad two will play starting on instrumental two and on the entirety of the bridge. So let's dive right in. We're going to start with learning the lead one part. So lead one starts on this F note right here, and we go F, E, D, E, and then E, D, E, and then C, D, E, G, A, and that's the high G and the high A. And then we repeat that pattern, but instead of doing the high G to the high A, we do a low A to a low G. So altogether, that sounds like this. Alright, so that's lead one. Again, you play that on the intro, instrumental one, and then the outro. So then we're going to jump to lead two. Make sure, there we go. Lead two, there's a lot of C's that we play. And then intermittent with those C's, we start off with C, 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 G, E. So that'll sound like this. And then we go C, 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 G, F. And then C, 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 B, A. And then B, 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 C, D. And then a lot of the second half of that is similar. So this is the second half of lead two, C, 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 G, E. C, 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 G, F. And then we hold out longer C's. And we hold that B note out for the end of the choruses. So this is lead two altogether. And you can hear that last part with the C's to the B. You're almost doing the C notes on the quarter notes. So that's lead two. Let me get back down into the pad one section just so you can hear what that's like. You mostly just hold the C, and then when it goes to C over F, the bass note will take priority, so we hold that F. And for the A minor 7, we just play that root. And then for the G, we play that root. And of course, if you are using your left hand to play the root notes in the choruses, that's two measures of C, two measures of F, two measures of A for the A minor, and two measures of G. The difference on the second half of the chorus is it's two measures of C, two measures of F, one measure of A, one measure of G. And then finally, the last section is for instrumental two into the bridges. It's a lighter pad. So you just sustain that through instrumental two, and then for the first part of the bridge, you hold the two measures of C, two measures of F, again, two measures of C, two measures of F. You do that a couple times, and then the last few measures of the bridge, you go to the A minor, hold the C again, and then finally we hold the F, where the song leader is singing worthy, worthy, worthy. And then the chorus. So that's pretty much it for This Is Amazing Grace. I'm going to go ahead and let the song play, and I'll play a little bit along with the song. It's going to be slightly difficult for me jumping from section to section using the keyboard that I have in front of me. But I think that as you see where I'm jumping to, I want to make sure that you have a visualization for which zone you're going to jump to at the different parts of the song. So yeah, let's go ahead and play through This Is Amazing Grace.
1, 2, 3, 4, intro. 2, 3, 4.
So I totally botched the end of that. Let's see. There we go. So a lot of times on these songs, because we'll be changing the patch pretty instantaneously, you won't even hit anything as we ring out. But if we are for any reason ringing something out, once we hit that low A, just go ahead and ring out on the root. And that'll be what we use to finish the song. So that's it for This Is Amazing Grace. Let me know if you have any questions, and I'll be sure to respond to those as soon as I possibly can. But otherwise, enjoy playing This Is Amazing Grace, and we'll see you soon.